You're watching UNICEF television. Farzana Fayaz is rebuilding her life, brick by brick. She's racing against time to construct a shelter for her children. The cruel floods that ravaged northeastern Pakistan left her with nothing. Nothing but a burden of grief.
I make bricks myself to build my house. I'm worried about my children. In the night, it becomes very cold. We do not have any warm clothes, no food, no covers or bedding, absolutely nothing.
Nature seems to have no mercy for millions like Farzana. They were forced to flee their homes when the waters were rising. 4 months after the calamity struck, they're slowly heading back to face the aftermath. But all roads seem to lead nowhere. Their misery is unending, and it's the children that are suffering the most. Without food or shelter, they're vulnerable prey for the biting cold.
We had to flee because of the catastrophic floods. We were so worried. We stayed with our relatives in Multan for 1 month before returning home. My 2 children felt sick and became very weak. We didn't have food or milk to feed them. There were no medicines for their treatment.
UNICEF has been working to meet the basic needs of the displaced. The organization has set up health clinics like this one that treat malnourished children.
We've started this new program. We're registering all the patients. The malnourished children are being given plumpy nuts, and the ones with other complications and diseases are being treated as well. We continue to follow up with the patients, and we have noted a marked improvement.
UNICEF is also making efforts to restore normalcy in the lives of students with makeshift learning centers.
The floods destroyed our school, and a camp was open here. I study in the camp, and my sister and my brother are also attending school here.
But these are only stitches to the wounds that need long-term treatment. Today, Pakistan desperately needs a tidal wave of assistance from the international community. Support that would pull these people out of their emotional paralysis and help them walk again. This is Priyanka Pruthi reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, go to unicef.org. Unite for Children.